Hey everybody, how are you? We are live tonight. Oh, not yet. Hey everybody, how are you? We are live tonight. We are live tonight. Come on in. There is a word from the Lord. Just waiting for you guys to come on in. Anytime. I don't know what to do. I will cast all my cares upon talk about that tonight. Oh, come on in, everybody. Come on in. Come on in. We are praying. There's a word. I have a word from the Lord. I have a word from the Lord. Amen. I'm just waiting for y'all to come on in.
Thank you.
Caught up in my worship right now. God bless you, Dana. God bless you, Dashawn. How are you guys doing? I hope everybody is well. I have a word from the Lord that I have to share that God has just dropped in my spirit and I want to share. I'm just trying to wait for some other people to come on. Can you do me a favor, everybody? Can you please share this video? Prophet Dashawn, I need to talk to you. I need some help. I need your help. Hallelujah. I need your help. I know you probably upset with me, but I love you. Please give me a call tomorrow if you can. Dana, listen, please share this video and just let me know that you shared. Amen. I have to do a better job of sharing videos. Please share the video, Dana, if you don't mind. We're praying for California. It looks like there are more fires. Yeah, Dana, it looks like there's like more fires in California. Let me know if I'm correct about that. More fires in California. Please let me know. Come on in, everybody. Come on in so we can share the word of the Lord. Amen. And what the Lord has to say tonight. I want to just share this word. I want to drop it in your hearing. Amen. Then we're going to pray. This is day 7. Hey, Henrietta. How are you, darling? This is day 7 of our 30 days of intercession. For the month of September, we are in intercession. This is day number 30. So please, ma'am, please, sir. Everybody that's up here, thank you, Dana, for sharing. Henrietta, please share this video. Please share. I have to do a better job with sharing. Please share this video. Please. I forget to ask people to share. But if you don't mind, real quick, just hit the share button. Amen. Let's go ahead on. Amen. Thank you, Dana. Yes, more fires. I saw it on the news tonight. I was reading it. I was reading on my news feed. So we got to pray for, we have to pray for California. Amen. We're going to be praying for California tonight. Amen. So please, Henrietta, please go ahead and share the video. Sashan, if you can, please share the video. Let me know that you were able to share it.
My soul, the lover of my soul, the lover of my soul, the lover of my soul.
Help me worship. We're about to go in. I have a word from the Lord that I have to share tonight. Hallelujah,
my soul, lover of my soul, God.
Yes.
Lover of my soul.
He's the lover of my soul. God bless you, Mary. Thank you for joining us tonight. Please, Mary, go ahead and share this video tonight. Please let me know that you have shared. Everyone that is sharing, please let me know that you have shared the video tonight. Amen. I have this word from the Lord that I want to release on tonight. I have to release this word tonight. Please share the video. Please share this video. Mary, if you would, share the video and just let me know you shared. Dana, thank you for sharing. Henrietta, I don't know if you shared or not, but please let me know if you had shared this video on tonight. Amen. Please share the video on tonight. I am excited about what God is about to do. I'm so excited about what God is getting ready to do. And it's so awesome. It's so spectacular what God is getting ready to do. So please let me know. Let me know. We're getting ready to get started. I'm going to take about 2 more minutes, and then we're going to get ready. Thank you, Mary. Thank you for sharing. Bless you, sis. God bless you for sharing this on tonight. Amen. I don't know if Henrietta is still on. Henrietta, I need you to share this on your page, darling, for me. Hallelujah. I'm excited about what God is getting ready to do. It's so awesome. I'm going to make some announcements while we're waiting. So I have this shirt on tonight. It says 12. Okay, hold on. 12 at 12. 12 minutes of prayer at 12 midnight. Amen. I'm sharing for my mentor, amen, Prophet Andre Cook. He doesn't even know, but I got my shirt. It is 12 at 12. What is it? 12 at 12. 12 minutes of prayer at midnight. 12 minutes of prayer at midnight. Those of you, especially California, you'll be up. It's like 9 o'clock at night. But it's only for 12 minutes unless the Lord leads him to go longer. But it's 12 midnight. I don't know where you are, Mary, but set your alarm 12 at 12. Amen. The prophet is on and he is praying. Amen. And God is just speaking. Yes, sir. God bless you. God bless you, man of God. If you could share, I would greatly appreciate it. 12 at 12. 12 at 12, everybody. Prophet Andre Cook, a trusted prophetic voice. Amen. I promise you, you will not regret it. Amen. It's just 12 minutes. 12 minutes. Amen. So if you can, please join us, amen, at 12 at midnight. Yes, sir. Yes, man. 12 minutes of prayer at 12 midnight. Yes, it is. It's powerful. That is, he is a mentor of mine. I have gleaned so much from him prophetically. And I just thank God for him. And I just thank God for what he's doing. So if you can, please join me, everybody. Amen. I'll be up there tonight. Lord, it's sometimes. Hallelujah. I'll be up there tonight. Prophet Daishan, God bless you, man of God. Thank you for being up here tonight. Sir, if you don't mind, please share the video. Henrietta, everybody that can, please share the video. Those of you that's coming on, please come on. Let me know who you are so we can greet you properly. I am excited about the word of the Lord tonight. I'm excited about the word of the Lord tonight. Amen. And we're getting ready to go forward and we're getting ready to share. Amen. I'm really excited about what the Lord is saying tonight. So the music that you're hearing tonight, everybody, it's called, it's from the IHOP, the International House of Prayer. You can YouTube them. They're on YouTube. It's 24 hours of worship and prayer. It is such a blessing. Sometimes I just let it play in my house. It's prophetic worship. It is awesome. I don't know if you know, I can't remember his name, but he started this. Nagel, I think that's his name. I can't remember. I cannot remember this man's name at all. But he started this. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for sharing. God bless you. I'm about to call you apostle. God bless you, Prophet Daishan. Thank you so much. Listen, if you guys can, take time to listen to this. It's the International House of Prayer, and they have 24 hours of praise and worship. Praise and prophetic worship. It is powerful. If you're enjoying what you're hearing, God bless you, Elder Cox. God bless you for joining us. Amen. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Pastor Cox, Bishop Cox, if you don't mind, can you please share this video? Please, and let me know that you have shared it. Let me know that you have shared it. Put a check mark. Just let me know that you have shared it. I want to release this word tonight. I'm getting ready to. I just thank you all for coming on. Thank you for your patience. Amen. I'm getting ready to shift. Listen, thank you guys for coming on. Thank you, Henrietta, for sharing. God bless you. Thank you for sharing. Bishop Cox, please share. Elder Bishop Prophet Apostle Cox, please share. Amen. Thank you, Prophet Daishan. Thank you, Mary. Thank you, everyone that is up here that have shared the video on tonight. Listen, I am so excited about what God is getting ready to do. God is doing some awesome things. Elder Cox, Bishop Cox, you hit the nail on the head. This is a season of intercession. There's so many pieces at play, amen, that's happening. There's so many things that's happening, but God is up to something. I need everybody to type that in. God is up to something. God is up to something. I was, today, you know, was the day off, so I was relaxing, you know, just chilling and relaxing. And there were some things that had transpired that I just wasn't happy about. I wasn't happy about them. And I was like, Lord. And I was like, oh God. And I knew I had to do this prayer tonight, this Facebook Live tonight. And I just was like, I'm going to be honest, didn't want to do it. Did not want to do it. But the Lord spoke to me and dropped something in my spirit. Now I'm all excited. Now I'm like, okay, come on, I'm ready to share it. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this Labor Day. We thank you, God, for all of us that have that are in the unions and those that are in a, that employed, that are employed and that have stepped into the labor movement, Father, Lord, that are blessing people to help them do something and to work. Father, I just praise all of the frontline people that are out there, the doctors and nurses, oh God, LP and CNAs, oh God, I bless them on tonight. Father, I bless your people, oh God, Lord, that those that have a job, I pray that they keep their job in the name of Jesus. I apply the blood of Jesus to every person that has a job, and that I decree and declare that you will not be in threat of losing your job in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, I declare that you will not be in threat of losing your job. I secure your employment in the name of Jesus. I pray for those that do not have a job but are looking for a job or need a job or want to transfer in their job. May the doors of heaven be open unto you, and may you know which door to go to. May the Holy Spirit reveal himself to allow you to know which door to go to. I call jobs forward. I call them from the north, from the south, from the east, and from the west. May the jobs appear. May you know the job, and may God open the door. And I pray for favor, that you will have favor to obtain the job. In Jesus' name, I just see a wave of or wealth of employment coming. I don't know who it is that's looking for a job, but I just sense in my spirit God is getting ready to open the door. There is a wave of employment that is coming. That is coming. Thank you, sir, for sharing. God bless you, man of God. There is a wave of employment that is coming. There is a wave of employment. Listen, if you know somebody that does not have a job, tell them they need to go and start applying, because there is a wave of employment that is getting ready to come now. How can people get a job in this time and this pandemic? It happens when you know God, and when there's an open door, and when there's favor attached to it. So Father, I thank you right now for the attachment. I thank you right now, God, that people will go and begin to apply, even those that are looking for new employment, but they felt that they could not go and get a job because of the times. I release you to go and look, because God is getting ready to blow your mind. Listen, Father, I thank you. Holy Spirit, speak to us. Give us ears to hear with the preciseness, keenness, accuracy, and clarity. Oh God, Lord, we thank you. We thank you. That's it, sis. I felt it. Listen, the job is yours. The job is yours. Father, we just agree with this woman of God that she will have this job. And God, even Lord, grant her favor upon the job coming into the door. Let her come. Oh God, even though she went for one position, Father, I decree and I declare that you're going to give her a higher position. Father, I just thank you, Lord. I thank you, God, because sometimes we apply for something that we're underqualified for. But Father, I decree and I declare that when she walks in the door, they will see that she is overqualified, and they will give her the position that's rightfully hers. In Jesus' name, I thank you. Listen, I feel very prophetic tonight. I feel a prophetic flow. Yes, Daishan, you know this. I listen 24 hours a day. Prophet Daishan, 24 hours a day. I don't even know what to do with myself, sir. I don't even know what to do with myself. I love this station. prophet does shine, if the Lord gives you something, please let me know so you can release it and share it. But what the Lord has said to me was this. I was having some kind of a day. It was going good. And towards the end, it kind of became kind of like, what am I doing? What's going on? What happened, Lord? And then, you know, sometimes when you're walking by faith, right, those what's come into play, right? Those what's come into play. But immediately I had to catch myself and I had to tell the Lord, God, you know what you're doing. I know you, God. I know you. I know you have a plan. I know that you're working it out. I know that all things are working together for my good. And sometimes when you're going through something, when the enemy is coming in, listen, when these things are happening, David encouraged himself in the Lord. You must encourage yourself in the Lord. When the enemy comes in like a flood, God lifts up a standard. You must learn how to encourage yourself in the Lord. So immediately I started just talking to myself and saying, no, Darcy, you will trust in the Lord. You will trust in God. You will realize that God has a plan. It may not feel good to you right now, what you're going through and what you're enduring and what you're seeing. It may not feel good to you right now, but all you have to do is hold on to the horns of the altar and realize, and listen, and not let go, and realize God has a plan. There is something specific that God is getting ready to do. What I realize is this. There are a lot of prophetic words that are being released in the earth. God is speaking expressly to his people. The Lord is speaking to his people. So, Father, right now, I decree and I declare, God, that your people will have an ear to hear what the Spirit is saying to them, what the Spirit is saying to the church. Father, I decree and declare that their ears, oh God, I decree and I declare, God, that their ears are only attentive to you, God. They are only attentive to what you have to say. Father, let them hear the sound. Father, like Pavlov's dogs, like he heard the sound when he rang the bell. Father, I pray now that when your body begins to hear the sound of the bell that is ringing from heaven, that we will begin to respond in the name of Jesus. Father, I praise you because you are releasing prophetic words. God, you are giving direction. You are leading us in the path of righteousness. Father, I praise you, God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Father, I praise you right now. I praise you right now. That's it, sir. There's a shift concerning finances. There is, sir. I feel it. I feel it, prophet. There is something that has shifted. Something has shifted. When we stepped into September, there was a shift. Listen, September is the number 9. I'm going to release this word. But September is number 9. 9 usually is 9 months that a woman carries a baby and she releases a baby. 9, 9, 9, 9. Yes, Mary, I'm telling you, God is speaking to you tonight. Hold on, woman of God. God has a word for you. Listen, 9, 9, 9, 9 is the month when a woman gives birth. She releases what she's been carrying. I've come to prophesy to people that have been carrying babies. I just heard the Lord say just that quick. You have been carrying babies, but your baby is overdue. Your baby is overdue. I prophesy to you tonight. I stand in the position of a midwife, and I command this baby that you have been carrying. Somebody's been carrying this baby for the space of 3 years. 3 years. You have been carrying this specific baby. It's like something you started. Was it a job or business? But something you started about 3 years ago. And you have been carrying this baby. And it's like you're asking the Lord, when, God, when am I going to give birth to this thing? How long do I have to toil with this? How long do I have to keep enduring this? I command by the Spirit of the living God, as I stand in the office of a midwife right now, I command your baby to be born. I turn the baby around. It will not be a breech baby. It will not, oh my God, it will not die in childbirth. But your baby is coming to life now in the name of Jesus. Now in the name of Jesus. You've been carrying this thing for too long. But tonight, God said you stepped into, hear this, the Spirit of the Lord said you have stepped into the birthing room tonight. Who am I talking to? You have stepped into the birthing room tonight. And I decree as a prophet of God, you will give birth tonight in Jesus' name. You will not miscarry. Some of you are worrying about the miscarry, but you under Bokosaba. Because you have miscarried before the things of God. But God said tonight, you will not miscarry. You will hold on to this baby. This baby will not slip through your hands. This baby will not be stillborn. This baby will come out in the right position. Who am I prophesying to tonight? Tonight is the fullness of time. Tonight is the time for you to release. Tonight, listen, the Bible says this in Exodus, that when Pharaoh has said that he had called for the midwives and for them to give birth, and the Bible says that the wives were in the birthing position. Who am I prophesying to tonight? The Lord said you are in your birthing position. You are in your birthing position. God said, I hear the Lord. You are in the birthing position. Not only are you in the birthing position, but there were times in time past they had to sit on a birthing stool. That was a way that the women had to give birth. They sat on this birthing stool, and I'm telling you, you are in a new position. Oh my God, I hear the Lord. Listen, we were expected to lay prone. You know how we, like a woman, when you have to give birth, you're laying on your back, but the Lord said, behold, I have changed your position, and now you are sitting upright, because the Lord says that I have aligned you. I have set you into alignment. You are in the birthing position, and you are getting ready to give birth. I say, Hande Bokustaba. I just heard the Lord say, happy birthday. Happy birthday. For tonight, you will give birth. For this is your birthing season, your birthing time. You have stepped into the proper position. My God, my God, my God, my God. All of the prophets are speaking one message, the message of the kingdom of God. Amen, amen, Bishop. Amen. The message, I'm telling you, God is up to something. God is causing us. God bless you, Prophet Finley. God is causing us to be in a birthing position. The word that I heard tonight, was, I looked and I was typing, and I was saying that this is day 7. We are doing 30 days of intercession. 30 days of intercession. And I'm telling you, the last time God called me to 30 days of intercession, there was something that I needed God to do. Listen, that I was praying for a very long time. I was praying for a very long time. And God called me to 30 days of intercession. And the word of the Lord was this. He said, do not miss a day. Do not miss one day. And I was like, Lord, 30 days. But God said, do not miss one day. And because I went through that 30 days of intercession and did not miss a day, God literally, I saw the hand of God move. I saw the hand of God move. Listen, I understand today is Labor Day. I wanted to rest. I wanted to relax. But God said, do not miss a day. And I am holding on to that for these 30 days of intercession. But as I was typing, and I began to type in, and I began to, God is placing us in the proper position. That's it. I mean, come on, Dana, you are absolutely right. I'm telling you what I see in the spirit, because usually when a woman gives birth, she's laying on her back. She's laying down. But this position, you are in an upright, hear the word. You are seated in an upright position. And I'm telling you, that is the perfect alignment of the Lord for us to be in an upright position. And God is causing us to bear down and to give birth. And the Lord said this to me while I'm trying to get to it. Amen. God's hand is moving. Yes, his hand, God's hand is moving. Yes, it is, sis. Listen, so as I was typing, and I typed up that this is the seventh day. This is the seventh day of intercession. And the meeting, when I said that, like I could feel like God was trying to get my attention about it being the seventh day of prayer. The seventh day of prayer. God bless you, prophet. God was dealing with me about this seventh day. Seven means the number of completion. Seven means completion. It means coming to an end. So listen, I want to read this to you. Completion, it means the action or process of finishing something. Work on the state of being finished. Hear me what I'm saying. Hear the word of the Lord. What does complete mean? Having all parts or elements, lacking nothing, whole, entire, full, a complete set of mark. Twain's writings, finish, ended, concluded, a complete orbit, having all the required or customary characteristics, skills, or the like, consummate, perfect in kind or quality, a complete, listen, I'm going to read this one more time. It means to complete, hear me, it's a form of an adjective. Having all parts of elements, lacking nothing, whole, entire, full, lacking nothing, whole, entire, full. I come to prophesy tonight that we have stepped into a season of completion. We are coming into a place. If I was preaching, I would tell somebody to get up and run, get up and jump, get up and shout, slap your neighbor. Listen, I'm going to say it again. Complete means lacking nothing, whole, entire, full, lacking nothing, whole, entire, full, lacking nothing, whole, entire, full. When a woman comes into her birthing time in her 9 months, when she gives birth, she releases it. I am prophesying to you tonight. There it is. You're catching this thing in the spirit, Mary. Lacking nothing. Full, whole. I prophesy to you tonight that you have entered into your season of lacking nothing. You have entered into your season of fullness. answer. You have entered into your season of completeness. This thing, oh my God, is coming to an end. The cycle, I just heard the Lord, the cycle is being broken and the cycles are coming to an end. I'm repeating it because the Lord wants you to hear this. This is your season of completeness. This is your season of lacking nothing. I'm going to read the definition again because we have to get this. We have to get this. It says these words, having all parts or elements. I'm prophesying now. Lacking nothing, whole, entire, full. 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 Hear the word of the Lord. You have stepped into your season of lacking nothing. You are coming to a season of experiencing the wholeness of God. Whole, W-H-O-L-E, the wholeness of God. There is a completion of the whole matter. Who am I talking to tonight? God is speaking to you. There is a completeness. There is an end. You are going to into a season of lacking nothing. You are coming into a season of wholeness, of full. You are getting ready to experience the entirety of God. Oh my. Oh my. You are getting ready to experience the entirety of God. That means the thing that God has promised you, you are getting ready to release it in this season of birthing. You are getting ready to release it in the season of wholeness, the season of lacking nothing. Come on. Whole, entire, full, lacking nothing. Thank you, Mary. Whole, entire, full, lacking nothing. Whole, entire, full, lacking nothing. I don't care if you had tried it before tonight. I am prophesying to you, telling you that you have stepped into the season of completeness. Today is 9, giving birth month, the 9th month, the 7th day. Come on, somebody, hear the word of the Lord. We have stepped into the 9th month. On the 7th day of the 9th month, you have stepped into the month of completion. You have carried this thing long enough. And God said, this is the season that I, God, have ordained you to bring it to pass. You have been carrying this too long. But I decree and declare unto you, you will not miscarry, you will not overcarry, but you will give birth in the proper season. The baby will come out in the proper position. I declare to you, this is your month of birthing. Oh my God, this is your month of birthing. Yes, that's right. We are going to experience the entirety of God. What that means is everything that God has ever promised you. This is the hour to look for the thus says the Lord. This is the hour to look for the thus says the Lord. I'm going to say that again. This is the hour to look for the thus says the Lord. For verily God has spoken some words to you. And it seemed about soba. I just saw like like there's words over your head. And for some of you, there's a particular word that's hovering over your head and you have not seen the manifestation. I'm specifically speaking to the people that just have said to the Lord, God, what is going on? Your conversation with the Lord was, God, how long? How long? How long? How long? How long? You literally just said those words to the Lord. You are who I am talking to tonight. And the Lord speaks expressly to you tonight to let you know, now is the time that I am releasing. Now is the time that I'm bringing it all to pass. I'm accumulating it and I'm bringing it to pass. I hear the Lord saying, I am literally setting it into motion. I hear the Lord saying, I am setting it into motion. You've been waiting, you've been praying, you've been fasting, you've been waiting on the Lord. But the Lord said to tell you, I have set it into motion. This is the seventh day. I'm reminded of the scripture. The Bible says that when the enemies came up against Moses, one of the things the Lord said was that the enemy that you see today, you will see again no more forever. I am prophesying to you tonight to let you know you have stepped into a cycle of completeness. You have said, I don't care who comes and goes tonight. I know this is a word from the Lord. I know this is a direct word from the Lord. And if you will grab hold of this word, I am telling you, that was my conversation with God this morning. I know it was. I know that you're not the only one, Prophet Finley. I know you are not the only one. I heard the Lord say that this is particular for the ones who ask that question, how long, God? How long am I going to have to endure? How long am I going to have to wait? And the Lord says to let you know, I, God, have set this in motion. I know you're not the only one. There were other people that have released that word just today. You said to God, what is going on? How long do I have to endure this? How long? How long? That's it. Prophesy. Bye-bye, enemy. I love that. I love that. That's right. I'm telling you, the enemy that you see today, you will see again no more forever, because God has released the word. God has released his word. We have been teaching on this Facebook Live that what God has said, the Bible says this in Isaiah, I believe the 55th chapter, the Bible says the words that come out of God's mouth, the word that has come out of God's mouth, Tashan, cannot return void, but it must accomplish that which it was sent out to do. Prophet Daishan, what the Lord said to me was this, and we God lives on the inside of us, right? The Spirit of the living God, the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit lives on the inside of us. And the word was this, hear me, the word was this, the word was that when we open up our mouth and speak, it is the word of God that is speaking through us. And when that word is released out of our mouth, that word cannot return void. Prophet Daishan, even if that word that has come out of our mouth has not been created as of yet, that word still cannot return void. It has to go out and find a way for it to happen. Even if the word has to create it itself, it must come to pass. It cannot go back. It rained here in Florida. Not one time did that rain cease and return back into heaven. And the Bible says this, as the rain and snow cannot go back into the heaven, neither can the word that goes out of God's mouth. Neither can the word that goes out of God's mouth. Neither can the word. I see you, Mary. Neither can the word that has gone out of God's mouth. I am so sure of this word tonight. I am telling you, this is the word of the Lord. God said, listen, this, he's bringing it to completion. I would turn around and tell you to tell your neighbor, it's over. Tell him it's over. It's over. It's over. All things are working together for my good. God is mixing it in the bowl of heaven, and he's mixing and he's mixing. I just heard the Lord say this. He's mixing it because he is preparing a table before you in the presence of your enemies. Who am I talking to tonight? God is literally preparing a table before you in the presence of your enemies. That's why he said all things are working. It's working. It's mixing. He's shaking it. He's putting it together. He's pulling pieces from here and pieces from there. And he's pulling it together because his word that went out of his mouth was, all things will work together for your good. It can't return void. That word cannot change its mind. It is on assignment for good. Oh my God. It is on assignment for good. That word must prosper good. It must bring forth good. It has to happen. It has to happen. It has to happen. He's working all things out after the counsel of his own will. Why do you think all things are going to work together for your good? Because God has, he's working all things out for the counsel, after the counsel, after his own counsel. Everything that God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit has taken counsel on, they've sat there, and one by one, throughout your life, they had already taken counsel of what will happen, what's going to happen, where your prosperity is going to be, when it's going to happen. Counsel has already been taken. And because of that, hear me, that is why it's all going to work together for your good, because it has already been established, hear me, before the foundations of the world. There is, what you're going through is no surprise to God. It's not like God sees what's going on and he's looking and like, I didn't see that coming. No. He does all things after his own counsel. They have already decided it was already decided that you were going to be on this Facebook Live at 7 at 8 o'clock tonight. Before the foundations of the world, when they sat and made counsel, the Bible says to Jeremiah, in Jeremiah the first chapter, before we were put into our mother's womb, God knew us. He ordained us to what we would be. He made some apostles, prophets, pastors, evangelists, and teachers. He made some. It has already been established. There's nothing new under the heavens. What God said he would do, he will do. He has already predestined. It's working. It's working. Somebody type that in. It's working. Type it in. It is working. It may not feel like it. It may not look like it. And matter of fact, it may look like the opposite of what God said right about now. It may actually look like the opposite of what God said. But I declare unto you, It's working. Come on, somebody type that in for me tonight. It is working. It is working. It is working. Thank you, Prophet Finley. Thank you, Mary. It is working. It is working. Come on, type it in. It is working. There is a shaking. Yaban de costa ba. Ramandio sikohoshi yaba. There is a shaking that is taking place in the spirit realm. There's a shaking. And this shaking is causing the workings of the Lord. The shaking, ayah boho shama, is causing the working of the Lord. There are things that God has set inside as He's beginning to set in motion. There are some things that God has set aside and He's causing it to work. I see Saba ko shama. The Bible talks about the clay. He talks about the clay. And that he had to break the clay and remake it because it was marred. I'm prophesying to people that have gone through marred situations these last couple of months. Oh my God. I'm prophesying to people who have experienced things being marred. Just being marred, scraped up, broken. Not in the fullness. It's just marred. It's just marred. It has spots on it. It's marred. I'm prophesying to you tonight. Because that thing which was marred in the master's hand, he's getting ready to create it anew. He's yisto bokusta masha. He's ginda bokusta masheke. He's getting ready to bring it to pass. I'm prophesying now. I'm prophesying now. He's getting ready to bring it to pass. What you thought would not happen, God is saying, I'm getting ready to do it. I'm getting ready to cause it to come into a full effect. I hear the Lord, what was marred once in my hand, what was marred, I'm about to make it over again. What was marred, God said, I'm about to make it over again. I can't make people stay on. I can't make you stay on. But all I can do is give you the word of the Lord. That's all I can do is give you the word of the Lord. I cannot make you stay on. But the word of the Lord is so simple tonight that this is the season of completeness. That we have stepped into the season of completeness. A fullness, an entirety, a wholeness in the month of birthing. In the month of birthing, the Lord, I am establishing, says the Lord. But the Lord says, I am completing a thing. I am completing a thing. I am completing a thing, says the Lord. I'm bringing it to full circle. This is the hour of completeness. I hear the Lord say, ask again, ask again, ask again, ask again, ask again. I hear God saying, ask again. Do not wait, ask again. Because God is bringing it full circle. I see you, Dana. God is bringing it full circle. He's bringing it full circle. I don't know who this is for, but I just heard the Lord say, relocation. I don't know who that's for, who's been praying about relocation. But this is your time of relocation. This is your time. You was wondering, should I? This is your time of relocation. God is bringing things full circle. Full circle, full circle, full circle, full circle. Do not hold back. Go hard after God. Go hard after God. Do not hold back. Give God everything you have. Give Him everything you have. Because this is a time of wholeness, entirety, completeness, fullness. He's aligning you. He's causing you to be in an upright position to give birth. Ecclesiastes says it like this, there's a season and a time for everything. This is your time and your season. This is your time and your season. I'm going to say it again. This is your time and your season for the release of God. Yokoboho Shama. Shandede yo shatamakumia.
I
hear God saying, I am completing it. I hear the Lord saying, I am completing it. I don't know what your it is, but I need you to know tonight, September 7th, that God said, I am, He's the I am, completing it. I am completing it. I'm bringing it full circle. Utamashaya, I'm bringing it to a place they call Shabbat. A place of full completion. And once I complete it, says the Lord, you will not have to go back over it again. Once I complete it, says the Lord, you will not have to go back over it again. You won't have to go back over it again. You won't have to go back over it again. I am bringing it to completion. I just hear that. I'm fulfilling the promise, says the Lord. I'm fulfilling the promise. What has God promised you? What did you scribe? What did you write down? What did you and God come into agreement with? That's the thing that He's about to perform. That is what He's getting renda ba kusta ba. Yeto mo kusti amasheke. Yande bo kundi asamashika. Denda ba kusta tabakea. Ramando bo kosheki abahaya. That is the thing that I am completing, says the Lord. That is the thing that I am completing, says the Lord. I'm bringing into the fullness of time, to the fullness. Listen, I'm getting ready to pray. I'm getting ready to pray. I feel the presence of the Lord. Ora masore de Dio shandara da bahia. Ora mando bokura de da masia. Ora na mando bokoshe da bahia. God is getting ready to do it. I thank you for hanging in. Those of you that stayed on, I thank you for staying on. God is getting ready to do it. What I'm sensing in my spirit are things that he has foretold you, things that he has said that he was going to do, and it just seemed like it wasn't going to happen. The enemy is showing you that it's not going to happen. The word of the Lord to you tonight is that I'm bringing it into completeness. It's time to complete what I, God, have promised. If you agree with the word of the Lord tonight, type amen. I'll wait. If you agree with the word of the Lord tonight, I just need you to type amen. We're getting ready to pray. I can't say anymore because I'm not released to say anymore. I said everything that I believe the Lord once wanted me to say. If you believe the word of the Lord tonight, type amen. Type amen. Just type it in. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to the Lamb of God. If anybody has any prayer requests, thank you, everybody. If anybody has any prayer requests, I see you, Mary. I see you, Dana. I see you, Carolyn. If anybody has any prayer requests, please put it in. We're getting ready to pray. I'm done. I'm finished. Once again, I want to remind everybody. Let me show you my shirt. 12 at 12. 12 at 12. Amen. Prayer. Where is it at? Okay. Prayer. 12 minutes of prayer at 12 midnight. Amen. 12 minutes of prayer at 12 midnight. It's 12 at 12. I'm going to get me a shirt made. I like these shirts. It's 12 at 12. If you're up, you're on the East Coast and you're up at 12 midnight, jump on. Type in Life Chapel, amen, or Prophet or Andre Cook. You can go on his page, amen, or you can come on my page because he's always on my page and be a part of that. For those of you that's in California, it's only 9 o'clock at night for you guys. So please jump on. Thank you for all your amens. Thank you, Henrietta, for your amen. Amen. Listen, we're getting ready to pray. I have said what the Lord had wanted me to say tonight. I have released the word of the Lord. I feel very confident in this word. I know that this is what the Lord is saying. That what, oh God, the enemy that we have seen today will see again no more forever. We have stepped into a season of completeness, entirety. Wow, 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 wow. We are about to see God's glory. We're about to see his glory. We are about to receive his glory. Amen, Mary. We're coming into agreement with you, sis. We believe the word of the Lord. We believe it. We believe that you will. Come on, somebody. Let's come into agreement with Mary right now. Those of you that are up here, you know what we do. We type in, I agree. Father, we come into agreement right now for Mary. Lord, we thank you, God, for her new job. We thank you for her new position. We thank you, oh God, Lord, that even coming into the door of the job, she will have favor and that she will have a new position higher than the position that she was looking for. Oh, what's going on with Sister Lola? Higher than the position that she was looking for. Father, I thank you right now. I thank you right now, God, for her here. We agree right now. We agree right now. Come on, that's it. Thank you. Thank you guys for coming into agreement with me for our sister. Amen. Our sister Mary. God, let the phone ring. Let the phone ring. Let the phone ring. And God, let it only be good news. Let it only be good news. Let it only be good news, God. For Lord, her season of waiting is over, oh God. So Lord, let it be good news in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Lord. We all come into agreement. We agree with God. Because God, you said that that whatever we ask in Jesus' name, you will do it. Father, we are asking in Jesus' name that you give Mary this job, that you give her this job in the name of Jesus. And I just see a whole new position for you, Mary. I don't know why I keep saying that, but I just feel that the position that you apply for, it's like you're going to get another position. I know what you applied for, but you're going to get another position. I just sense that. I don't know what that's about, but you'll get another position in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, thank you guys for coming into agreement. Amen. What is going on? Amen. Yes, Sister Mary. Yes, Sister Mary. Was that the job that you are that you're believing for a phone call? Was that, like, I know you applied for that job, but was that the ideal job that you wanted, or could it have been like another position, but you was like, let me just be safe and go for this position, Mary? Is that the case? I don't know why I feel like that for you, that you could have went for another position, but you wanted to be safe and you went for this position. I don't know. I just sense that. I just sense that. I sense that. Amen. Sister Mary, let me know. Let me know what that's about. Why am I sensing that? Because I feel another position for you. I feel another. Yes. Okay. Thank you. I know I'm not crazy. You could have, like, and I just feel like you just took like the safer position. That's it. Thank you, Mary. And God is getting ready to give you that position, the one that you should have went for. Because I believe, I guess it's more money or whatever, but you didn't think you were qualified for it or whatever the case may be. But God is getting ready to give you that position. Amen. We thank you, God, for that confirmation. We thank you for it, Lord. And we just know, God, if you brought that to light, then that means you're going to do it. So we just thank you. You just let us know what you got it. Amen, Mary. Amen. Amen. That's it. So we totally agree. Only thing we need for you, sisters, to come back and give your testimony. Amen. It wasn't open. Okay. But it's open now. It's open now. Lord, we thank you. Mary, we're just waiting for your testimony. We're waiting for the testimony. And we are believing God for your testimony. Amen. We are believing God for your testimony. Wow. Amen. Amen. And amen. My God. Lord, we just thank you for the victory. We agree. We agree. We all just came into agreement. Amen. Prophet Finley, you said pray for Sister Lola. What's going on with Sister Lola so we can pray for her? Amen. Amen. That's the word of the Lord. That's the word of the Lord. That is the word of the Lord, Henrietta. Amen. Amen. That's what we do. We come into agreement. We don't be playing. We come into agreement. We agree with what God is doing, what heaven is doing. We come into agreement and intercession. I'm getting ready to pray. Prophet Finley, can you let me know what's going on with Sister Lola? Specifically, if you can share, let us know. Amen. Amen. So, Father, right now, God, we lift up Sister Lola before you right now. And Father, we speak exactly this word that Prophet Finley has put up there, that every organ to function properly. Come on, everybody, I need you to come into agreement. Father, we come against infections in the name of Jesus. We decree and declare that every organ, Okata Mashanda Bakaya, is coming into order. It will function properly in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Dana. Thank you. Thank you. Every organ to function properly, and that it will come into, it will come into, it will function properly. Father, you're even the God that can give new organs. You're even a God that can give new organs. We come against the swelling. Father, what the devil meant for evil, we decree and declare that it will work for her good in the name of Jesus. Father, we just thank you, Lord, that come against sepsis, and we come against any affections, Lord. And we declare that her organs are operating properly tonight in the name of Jesus. You said in your word that I am the Lord that healeth thee. Father, we come as intercessors. We are standing in the gap on behalf of your daughter, and we thank you in advance for the peace. We thank you for the completeness, O God, for bringing her into completeness, Lord, a fullness and a completeness in the name of Jesus. We thank you, it's done in Jesus' name. Anybody else has any other prayer requests that we can pray on tonight? In the name of Jesus, amen, Mary. We decree that over her. We declare that over her in the name of Jesus. Sotaba, sonda mashanda bakota bakista tabaka. Ramande de na bokuna na mashika. Oh God, you're so welcome, Sister Prophet Finley. You are so welcome. Amen. Season of entirety. So Father, heal. That's it. Heal her entire body. I like that, Mary. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Father God, we just lift up the body of Christ before you, Lord. Father, we just thank you, Lord, that you are maturing your body, that you're bringing your body into completeness and wholeness, and that they will know the entirety of God. I thank you, Lord, that you are raising up a body in the name of Jesus. Hey, Lucy, you're raising up a body, God, of believers, Lord, that will stand and declare the word of the Lord. Father, we thank you, Lord, that your church will become the intercessors that you have established them to be, that you want them to be. Father, put the burden and passion of intercession on the body of Christ, in the body of Christ. Help us not to think it's only for a certain group of people, but Father, I ask you right now in the name of Jesus to raise up the body of Christ. God, help us, oh God, let our eyes be open, let our ears be attentive, Father. Give us ears to hear you with clarity, oh God. Lord, put a burden for souls back into the body of Christ. Put a burden for souls back into the body of Christ in the name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you, Mary. God bless you, sis. Put, Father, we pray right now for the body of Christ, that you will give us a backbone, that you will make us strong, that we will stand, oh God, and decree and declare that we will raise up, oh God, we will stand and wage war against the enemy. Father, we will go out and witness, we will snatch out of hell, God, the souls that the enemy is trying to take. Father, we pray right now, God, that your people will come into a place of deliverance in the name of Jesus. Oh God, I thank you right now, Lord, that you, Father, are bringing us the body of Christ, Lord, your bride, Father, that we will go out into the highways and the hedges and compel them to come, God. Put a burden for souls back into the body of Christ. In the name of Jesus, I pray, Lord, that we once again will have a burden for souls. Put a cry in our spirits. God, let us cry loud and spare not. Let us lift up our voice like a trumpet in Zion. Father, raise up your people, oh God, to cry according to 2 Chronicles 7:14. For you said, if your people, which are called by your name, will humble themselves and pray and seek your face and turn from their wicked ways, then will you hear from heaven, forgive their sins and heal the land. Father, we thank you, God, that you are healing this land. Father, I pray, God, for the spirit of repentance, God, to come out of the body. Oh God, Lord, we repent for things that we did knowingly and unknowingly. We repent, God, for being judgmental. We repent, oh God, for backbiting. We repent, oh God, Lord, for not standing up and declaring, God, the word of the Lord when we were supposed to declare the word of the Lord. We repent for not praying when you woke us up to pray. Father, we repent for not crying out on behalf of the land. Father, God, we ask for forgiveness in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray right now, God, that as we repent and turn, Father, let there be a turning back to you in the name of Jesus. God, let your church return back to you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Cause us to return. Cause us to return. Oh God, Lord, we pray for every backslider. May the backslider come back to you, Lord. Put a hook in their mouth, Father, in the name of Jesus. Put a hook in their mouth, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Put a hook in their mouth and bring them, draw them back to the foot of the cross. Draw them back to you, oh God. Lord, save our unsaved loved ones, our families, our friends, our neighbors and co-workers. God, save, God, this nation. Father, you said it is not your will that any should perish, but that all will come into repentance. Father, I pray that the body of Christ, Lord, that the people at large throughout this nation, God, even throughout the world, God, we pray for a global repentance in the name of Jesus. Let there be global repentance, Father. Oh God, I pray that you raise up intercessors globally, oh God. Lord, for you said, God, that you looked for a man to stand in the gap, but you could not find one, and therefore you had to bring destruction. Father, I pray that you do not bring destruction, but that, God, the intercessors will arise and take their rightful place. So, God, the pending judgment will be turned back. For, Father, we know in your word that you repented. You changed your mind. Lord, you repented for things that you were going to do. Father, I pray, God, that the church is aware, God, Lord, that you will stay your hand. You will command the death angel to stay its hand. Father, you will tell the enemy to back up. Father, if your people will pray, Father, I pray, God, that we will stop and we will understand that it's our intercession that releases you to do what you need to do on the earth and in the earth. Father, I pray now that, God, God, we will hunger and thirst after intercession. Oh God, we will make it the first thing that we do and the last thing that we do at night. Father, put prayer and intercession on our hearts. God, we pray for the homeless. We pray, oh God, for the drug addict, the alcoholic, God. We pray for those that are struggling with same-sex attractions. Father, we pray, God, we pray, oh God, for the President of the United States. We pray for mercy, oh God. We pray that you put somebody in his path that will minister truth to him. We pray that you will make an indention in his heart. Oh God, that you will give him the heart of God, the heart of love in the name of Jesus. For you said the heart of the king is in your hand, and you turn it whatever way you list, oh God. Father, I pray now, oh God, that you will turn the heart of the king. You will turn the heart, oh God, the heart of the president, the heart of the politicians, the heart of the government, oh God, for it is in your hands, Lord. Turn their hearts, oh God, Lord, the Republicans and the Democrats. Father, we pray for divine intervention. We pray, oh God, Lord, for a spirit of repentance. We pray for conviction, oh God, to rest upon this land. God, let the weight of your conviction from the White House, oh God, to the uttermost parts of the world. Father, we pray now in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray, God, for the nations, oh God of the world. Let there be repentance. Let your people fall on their knees and repent. Let your people fall on their knees and repent. Let there be a returning back to you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. God, cause us to repent. Cause us to turn back. Father, I pray for Africa. I pray for Niger. I pray for Chad. I pray for the Sudan. I pray for Libya and Egypt and Algeria. I pray now, oh God, for Zambia and Zaire and Tanzania and Kenya. I pray for Somalia, oh God. I pray for the continent of Africa. Father, in the name of Jesus, let there be repentance. Let the hearts return back to you. And those that don't know you, God, may they be introduced to you now. In the name of Jesus, we pray for North America. We pray for the United States of America. We pray for Canada. We pray for Mexico. We pray for South America. We pray for the West Indies. We pray now, God, for Honduras, oh God, for Ecuador, oh God, for El Salvador, oh God, for Nicaragua, oh God, for Panama, oh God, for Colombia, God, for Brazil and Bolivia and Argentina. We pray now, oh God, for our Latino brothers and sisters, our Caribbean brothers and sisters. Father, we pray that you heal the land. Oh God, let there be repentance in South America. Let there be repentance in the West Indies. Let them come back to you, oh God. Let a cry be made. Raise the church up, oh God, in South America. Raise up your ecclesia. Raise up the body of Christ. Let there be repentance. Let there be a turning. Turn their hearts back to you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for China. We pray for Mongolia. We pray for Kazakhstan. We pray now, oh God, for India. We pray for Malaysia. We pray now, oh God. We pray now, oh God. We pray now, oh God. Lord, heal the land. We pray for the Ukraine. We pray, oh God, let there be repentance in Russia. Let there be repentance in China. Let there be repentance in India. Let there be repentance in Japan. Let there be repentance, oh God. Let your people come back to you. We cry now for repentance. Let them come back to you. Let them come back to you. Oh God, don't let them be satisfied. Don't let them be satisfied until they make you their Lord and your Lord and Savior. Save this nation. Save this world. It's not your will that we perish, but that we will come into repentance. Father, we come on a global mission. Heal this land. Heal this land. Heal, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Heal us again, oh God. Heal us again. Heal Russia. Heal Russia. Heal Germany. Heal Austria. Heal, oh God. Heal, God. Heal, God. Heal us, oh God. Bring us back to the foot of your throne. For it was this cause that the Son of God came, that he will seek and save that which was lost. Father, we thank you for a global repentance. We thank you for a global cry. For we realize you are so soon to come back, Lord Jesus. God, we want to be ready. We want to be ready. We want to be ready. Father, we cry, oh God, for New York. I cry out for New York right now, oh God. For the state of New York, oh God, have mercy. Oh God, turn your hand. Turn the people back to you, oh God. Let a cry be made. Let there be a cry made in New York. From the city, oh God, to the upstate regions, to the borders of Canada. God, let there be a cry. I pray for divine protection. We come against terrorism. We come against terrorists, oh God. We come against the violence in the cities, oh God. Lord, turn your hand. Turn your people. Turn your people. Turn your people. Turn your people. Turn your people back to you, oh God. Father, we know that you can. We know that you're able. We know that you will. Father, we are your hands on the earth. Use our hands, oh God. We are your mouth on the earth. Use our mouth. We are your eyes on the earth. Use our eyes. We are your ears on the earth. Use our ears, oh God. Oh, Rabaso Kasha. Father, we lift up California. Thank you, Henrietta. Father, we lift up California. And as we prayed before, we pray again, because you, God, are a consuming fire. So, Lord, my prayer is that you, God, will consume the fires of California. Father, send rain. Send rain, oh God. Send the rain, oh God. Lord, we're asking for rain in this time of dryness, oh God. Lord, as the fires are trying to build up again, Lord, send a wind, oh God, of cool air, oh God. Not a wind to blow the fires, oh God, but the coolness, oh God. Lord, for you visit Adam in the coolness of the night, oh God. Lord, let there be a coolness that will come upon California. And God, consume the fires, oh God. Daddy, may the fires of God consume the fire of California. Father, I command the churches of God to rise up in California and take authority over these fires. In the name of Jesus, my God, you are a consuming fire. Consume the fire, oh God, like you did, oh God, with Baal, oh God, when they put the fire on the altar. God, you consume the fire. You are a consuming fire. Father, I pray for divine protection upon the people of God, their homes and their properties. We decree it will not destroy. It will not destroy. Father, I release Psalms 91 upon your people and their families, oh God. that only with their eyes, O God, will they behold and see, O God, the reward of the wicked. I decree and declare for your people that live in California, oh God, Lord, I decree Psalms 91, that it will not come nigh their dwelling. Father, I speak to those that are battling with asthma, God, and lung disease, oh God. I speak to them right now in the name of Jesus. I speak to the air quality, God. For Lord, I saw that big cloud and it looked like a cloud, but it was actually smoke. God, heal California. Oh God. Lord, bring your people to you. Bring your people back to you. Bring your people back to you. Bring your people back to you, oh God, in California. Let a cry go forth out of the Californian believers. Let them cry out, God, heal our land. Only you can do it. Daddy, only you can do it. Only you can do it, God. Father, may it not destroy the lands in California. It already broke the... It already made history. Father, let it make history in another way, that there was an overshadowing of rain, a rain that they've never seen in California. And in one day, God quenched these fires. You can do it, God. You said we have not because we ask not. I'm asking in Jesus' name that you, God, consume the fire. Because you are a consuming fire. I'm asking that you send the rain. Send the latter rain. Send the latter rain. Come on, I need everybody. We pray for rain. Father, we pray for rain. We pray for the coolness, oh God. The cold, oh God, that's coming down in the west, oh God. Lord, the coolness, oh God, to put out the fires, the rain to put out the fires. Lord, hold the lightnings back. Hold the lightnings back. I decree and declare that the lightnings are held back in the name of Jesus. Daddy, they need a miracle. And you, God, are a miracle-working God. Let me get my song, because you know that's next. Let me get my song, because you know that's next. Father, we thank you. We thank you, God. We thank you, Lord. Lord, we thank you. For we are decreeing an open heaven. We are decreeing an open heaven over California. Send the rain. Come on, can y'all type that in for me? Can y'all, if you don't mind, can you please type that in for me? Send the rain. We're asking God to send the rain. We're asking God for an open heaven. Thank you, Tracy. Hey, sis. Yes, God. Come on, let's declare an open heaven over California. May it rain, God. May there be rain. Thank you. Send the rain. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Tracy. Oh, Rabba Siko Hoshaya. Come on, type it in. No thing. Oh, come on, come on. Can y'all type that for me, please? Please type that. God, send the rain. Come on, send the rain. There it is, Mary, an open heaven over California. Let it rain. God, let it rain. Let it rain. Come on, declare that. Declare that. Let it rain, God. Let it rain. Let it rain. Let it rain, God. Oh, God, Lord, I know you said you wouldn't flood the earth again, but we're calling for rain, Father. We are calling for rain. We are calling for rain. Let it rain. Let it rain. Oh, Ramako, Ramasaya. There it is. Come on, intercessors. Come on, intercessors. Prophesy tonight. Prophesy tonight. We are under an open heaven. May the rain of heaven come down and quench every fire in California. Every fire, every would-be fire, every lightning. We command the lightning to cease in the name of Jesus. We command the lightnings to be held in the sky in the name of Jesus. And God, we say, let it rain. We say, let it rain. Let it rain. Let it rain. You've given us an open heaven. Let it rain, God. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Open the floodgates of heaven. Open the floodgates of heaven. May it rain, God. May you release rain in California, God. In Jesus' name. Come on, come on. Reveal your power, God. We are under an open heaven. Come on, prophesy, y'all. Prophesy, prophesy. I need somebody to prophesy over California tonight. Tracy, I need you to prophesy over California tonight. Come on, Tracy, I need you to prophesy over California tonight. Come on, y'all, I need you to prophesy over California tonight. What is the Lord saying? What do you want the Lord to say? Come on, open up your mouth and prophesy over California tonight. Father, may the fire stop in the name of Jesus. Flood California with your rain. Amen. Lord, shower us with glory. Come on, prophesy to California. I need everybody to prophesy to California tonight. Come on, Tracy. Lightning, be still. We speak to the cloud and command to release the rain from heaven. Thank you. Come on. We agree with that word. We agree with that word. We agree with that word. That God, Father, I pray, God, Lord, where your believers are, those that name the name of the Lord, God, those that are in relationship, God, send the rain. Oh, God, send the rain. Those people, oh, God, that are scattered throughout California, that are in covenant with you, God, douse them with rain. Send down the rain. Send down the rain, and where people will wonder and inquire why are certain places getting rained upon, their answer is because we serve a covenant-keeping God. Father, let it rain in California. May there be rain in California. Oh, God, we declare that they won't break another record on fires, but let them break a record of rainfall in California in the name of Jesus. Somebody help me prophesy tonight. There it is, Prophet Finley. No more lightnings. Oh, God, we speak to the dryness, and we command the dryness to be sucked up by the rain. May the rain encompass or cover the dryness in the name of Jesus. Let it rain. I see you, Mary. That's the word of the Lord. Let it rain. Rain now in Jesus' name. California, we speak miracles, signs, and wonders now, and speak to the fires and command you to cease now. Amen. Father, we release a cease and desist order upon California. Father, as I am as I am an officer of the courts of heaven, Father, tonight I release a cease and desist order upon California in the name of Jesus, and I command that the fire cease and desist in the name of Jesus. Father, I have the legal right. I have legal right to do this. We have legal right to do this. So, Father, we stand in our legal right as intercessors, And we say, let the rain cease, let the fire cease and desist. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, oh God, we impart, oh God, we implore the gates, the courts of heaven, oh God, Lord, that you would render a judgment upon California, that these fires will cease and desist, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Shower down upon us with your grace and mercy. Thank you, Jesus. Amen, Henrietta. Amen. No flooding, no lightnings, just rain to overwhelm the fires now in California. Amen, Prophet Henry. Amen. Amen. Finley, amen. Shower down. Jesus, you said, peace be still to the water. Oh God, greater works we shall do. We speak peace to the fires. Amen, Tracy. Let there be waterfalls in place of the fire. Come on, Mary. Amen. Lord, let your word manifest before this week is up. In Jesus' name, I agree. I agree with that word. I agree. I agree. I agree. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I agree. I agree. I agree. I agree. I agree. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Oh, Rabako Rebekinderioshataba. We agree tonight. We agree tonight. We agree with the word of the Lord. God, only you can do it. Only you. For God, you are a consuming fire. Consume. May the God of heaven consume the fires in California. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Yes, Lucy. Yes, Lord, we need a healing here in California. Amen, Lucy. We agree for the healing. Amen. We agree for the rain that's coming. We agree. Miracles, you are still working miracles. Amen. We agree. There's an open heaven over California. We agree. We agree. Send the rain, God. God, may you send the rain. Come on, let it rain, God. Oh, Rabba, Sekeboho Shanda. Rain, rain, rain. I love it. I love it. We are under an open heaven in California. That's right. Declare that, Californians. Y'all better declare that we are on. Thank you, Dana. We are under an open heaven. Amen. This fire will not make history. This fire will not break records. This fire will be put out as soon as it started. Father, I speak to the church in California. I command the church to take its legal right, its rightful place. I decree that the church will stand on its legal right and intercede and command the fires to cease and desist in the name of Jesus. I speak to the body of Christ in California and I say, stand up and take your legal right and prophesy and decree and declare that the fires will not rule, but you will rule the fires in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The river. Yes, God. Yes, God. Come on, rain, Lord. Yes, God. Yes, God. We command the lightnings to be still in the name of Jesus. Oh, Ramah, God, send us your light. Come on, Lord. Let it rain. 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 Come on, Tracy. California, we speak miracles, signs, and wonders now and speak to the fires and command you to cease and not and cease now in the name of Jesus. Let there be waterfalls, no more fires. Come on. We agree, we agree, we agree. California, thanks God for the rain. Amen. There it is. That's it. I love that, Prophet Finley. May California begin to speak and thank God and thank God and thank God for the rain. We have to speak those things that be not as though they were. Come on, Noah preached for 120 years and said that it was going to rain. They had never seen rain before, but he prophesied it was going to rain. You don't have to see the rain to come into agreement. You don't have to see the rain to prophesy rain. All you have to do, my brothers and sisters in California, is open up your mouth and prophesy rain. Prophesy rain. Prophesy. We implore the angels of God. Amen. Implore the angels of God, angels that excel in great strength and speed. We command you to bring the rain from heaven. We command you to do warfare in the heavenlies against every demonic force, every principality, every power, every ruler of darkness, all spiritual wickedness in high places. We command in the name of Jesus that the angels of God, the strong angel, Michael, the archangels, other archangels, we command you to bring the rain in from heaven into earth. We command you to do warfare in the heavenlies that is trying to stop the rain. We command the angels that excel in great strength and speed to do warfare in the heavens now in the name of Jesus and cause the rain to be released. Whatever is holding up the rain, we command the angels, the archangels, to displace, to pull down, to destroy every power, every ruler of darkness, all principalities. Come on, they are in high places, and we command the angels to do warfare now on our behalf, on behalf of California, and cause every demonic force that is holding up the rain to be removed in the name of Jesus. We prophesy rain. We prophesy rain. We say, let it rain in California. Let it rain. Angels, angels, we forbid any more demonic opposition that's bringing these fires. We command you to destroy them. May you come with your sword drawn, ready to do battle, ready to cut the heads off of every principality, every power, every ruler of darkness, all spiritual wickedness in high places that is causing these fires. May the angels of the Lord be released to push back. Come on. To push back all of these fires in the name of Jesus. And may the angels of the Lord strike the clouds and cause the rain. May the angels of the Lord strike the clouds and cause the rain. One more time. May the angels of the Lord strike the clouds and cause the rain in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We thank you for our intercession tonight. We thank you pushing back the fires and bringing your rain. That's it, Henrietta. Thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you for our intercession tonight. Father, we come into agreement with our sister Lucy. We thank you for her healing. We thank you for her healing. Angels, while you're coming to destroy the principalities, I need you to bring a new pancreas for my sister. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for her miracle. I come into agreement for Lucy's miracle right now. I come into agreement for Lucy's miracle right now, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Rabako Shandara Rabakande Bokusha Tabakaya. Father, we know that in heaven there's a room full of body parts. We know in heaven that there is a room full of body parts. Father, because we have a benefit of being your child, we ask in the name of Jesus that you give your daughter a new pancreas. We ask you for her complete healing. her complete healing. Her complete healing. We ask you for a miracle, signs and wonders. Angels, we say bring, come bring the body parts. Come bring it. Lord, we decree she will live and not die. We declare that she will have long life and you will satisfy her with long life. We thank you, God. We decree according to your word where you said, I am the Lord thy God that healeth thee. We hold you to your word. You are the Lord that heals, and we thank you. And we thank you, God, for you are the creator. You created the pancreas. So you can give her another one, or you can heal the one she has. God, however you want to do it, we say thank you for answering us. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Ora ma kora bashande de 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 na na bakaya. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. There it is. Lucy's miracle comes forth now. Complete healing for Lucy. God bless you, Evangelist Sheila. Thank you for coming up. Lord, we thank you, God. There is nothing too hard for you. There is nothing too hard for you, God. So we thank you for her miracle. God, we thank you for her miracle. She comes back every night because we are taking healing. Father, you said that we can receive. Another word for receive is to take. Father, we agree with Lucy as she takes her healing. We take healing for her. We stand in agreement and we take healing. God, the same word for receive is to take. Father, we take healing on behalf of our sister. And for anybody else that needs healing up here tonight, we take healing for them tonight in the name of Jesus. Anybody else that's up here that needs healing, we take healing for you tonight in the name of Jesus. May you be healed according to the word of the Lord. I am the Lord thy God that healeth thee. Jehovah Rapha, heal your daughter. I love that, Dana. Father, we thank you for Lucy. We thank you, oh God. We thank you. We thank you that Jesus was crushed. He was pierced and crushed. He was pulverized for Lucy's healing. And we agree with the work Christ did on the cross. We agree with the finished work of Christ on the cross. It is finished. It is finished. God bless you, Apostle. It is finished. We agree with the finished work of Christ on the cross. It is a done deal. And we just agree and we take healing. We take healing. We take healing. We take it. It is ours. It belongs to us. Father, we thank you tonight because you hear us. We say as Jesus said, as he stood in front of Lazarus' tomb and he said these words, Father, I know you hear me. And I know you always hear me. So Father, we agree and we say the same words tonight. Daddy, we know you hear us. And we know that you always hear us. That's why we know the fires are quenched in California. We know you're sending the rain. We know, God, that Lucy is healed. We know it. We thank you in advance. We give you glory and honor. Those of you, please share this video. All of you that are coming on, please share this video tonight. Please share this video. Tracy, please share this video. Amen. Please share this Facebook Live. Amen. Thank you. We agree, Apostle. We come into agreement with Lucy, and we command the body parts, the pancreas, to be released into her. We tell the angels, bring the pancreas, bring it and insert it. Oh God, there's nothing too hard for you. We agree with heaven. We agree with heaven. We agree with heaven. We agree with the word of the Lord. God, you said in Jeremiah 1 and 12 that you watch over your word to perform it. So we thank you. Yes, you are, Lucy. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Prophesy. Declare that woman of God, I am healed. I am healed. I love it, Lucy. I love it. I love it. And we agree. We agree with your healing. That's right. You have to say it. And we agree with what you have said. We agree with what came out of your mouth. And may the Lord hear it and may he answer. Because you said it. Even as you said it, may it be unto you tonight. Father, we thank you. Come on, lift your hands up, Lucy, and just receive it. Just take it. Take it. Take your healing. I see Nabokol Shataba. Oh, my God. With your hands up, I can just see like a garment. You know how like you lift your hands up to put your dress on and the person like pulls the dress over you? Lift your hands up. And allow God to dress you with his healing tonight, Lucy. Lift your hands up, Lucy, and allow God to dress you with his healing right now. Lucy, lift your hands up and allow God to put the garment of healing on you. Allow him to place the garment of healing on you tonight. In the name of Jesus. Dress her with your healing power in the name of Jesus. Father, we give you praise. We give you glory and we give you honor. I thank you that you're clothing her in healing tonight. Hey, Tanika. Thank you, Lord, that you are clothing her with healing tonight. Oh, Ramanda Bokushata Bakaya. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Ooh, I'm to anybody that's sick, anybody that has any sickness in their body, just lift your hands up and allow God to clothe you. Allow him to clothe you with healing. Father, clothe us with healing. Every pain go. Every sickness, every disease go. For God, you are clothing us tonight with healing. You are clothing us with healing tonight, and we take it. We take your cloth. We take the clothing of healing tonight. Oh, God, dress us in healing. Dress us in health. Father, we receive your healing tonight. Oh, we take it. We take it. We take it. We take healing. We take healing. We take it, God. For we are clothed with righteousness. Part of our righteousness is healing. And Father, we thank you for clothing us tonight. Wow, I feel the presence of the Lord. I feel the presence of the Lord. I feel him in my hands. I can feel the presence of the Lord in my hands. Father, I thank you for healing. Ora makore nereo shatabakaya. Lay hands on whatever part of your body. God is healing. The healing. God is clothing us with healing tonight. Take it. Take it. Take it. In the name of Jesus. Take it. Yes, the finished work of Calvary. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for clothing. I just feel like I just saw like a clothing. He's clothing. He's putting the garment on us. You know how like you like a woman, you get ready to get a dress and somebody's pulling it over your head? That's what I see in the spirit. God is clothing us with healing tonight. I saw that. And Father, we receive your, we dress us, God. We receive your dressing. We receive the clothing. We receive our garments of healing tonight. Oh my God. Father, we welcome your presence. We welcome your presence, oh God. We thank you for your visitation. Thank you for visiting us tonight. I feel the glory of the Lord. Lord, we feel your glory. Thank you, God. Oh, God, I thank you for the healing power of Jesus Christ. Yes, there it is, Mary. Total healing. God is clothing us with healing. Complete healing for Jessica even now, and we thank you. Complete healing for Doris Kelly. That's it. Come on, Tracy, decree it. Guys, if you know anybody that needs to be healed, declare that God is clothing them with healing. Declare that. Declare it right now. Anybody, Lord, we thank you for clothing Jessica with healing. We thank you for clothing Sister Kelly, Doris Kelly, with healing on her left side. We thank you, oh, Shata Maka. Mande Bekindi Bokora Ramahaya. We thank you for clothing the Styles family, God, with healing. We thank you for clothing them with healing right now. I mean, anybody that you know needs to be healing, you can just type their name and just thank God for clothing them for healing. That's all. Anybody that you know, if it's you or you know somebody that needs healing, I need you right now just to type in and say their name and say, Lord, we thank you for clothing them with healing. There it is. There it is. Thank you, Carolyn, for your obedience. Amen. Thank you. And we agree with you right now that Lola is being clothed with healing. Even as we speak, he's clothing her with healing right now in Jesus' name. Anybody else? Type in their names. Type in their names. Let us decree and declare. I'm getting ready to end. Amen. We thank you for clothing your people with healing. Thank you, Dana. There it is. Come on, type it in. Dress all your children that need healing with your divine garment. I love it, Mary. I love it. I love it. Lucy, thank you. In the name of Jesus, Lucy, you need to declare that you are clothed. You are clothed in the healing garments of Jesus. Lucy, declare that I am clothed in the healing garments of Jesus. Amen. God, I thank you for clothing Jessica. Amen, for healing and for clothing my mom with healing. Thank you for clothing. Come on, put their names up there. Sabrina with healing right now. Thank you, God, for clothing Tina with healing. Thank you for clothing Michelle's daughter with healing. Amen. Lord, we thank you for clothing Judy Yates with healing. Come on, y'all better type it in. Prophetic direction, prophetic direction, prophetic obedience. Get your prayers answered. Amen. Lord, I thank you. Come on, put it in, put it in, put it in, put it in. Come on, anybody else? Lord, we thank you that you're clothing Karen with your healing garments. Thank you, Father. Come on, put it in. I agree. I agree. I agree. I'm coming into agreement. I'm coming into agreement. I'm typing in my own name. Come on. Come on. Lord, we thank you for clothing Donna and Vita and myself in the healing clothing. Amen. Lord, I thank you for clothing me. Yes, God. Hallelujah. Come on, I'm getting ready to end with your healing garments. Amen. Ooh, God, I thank you in Jesus' name. Oh, my God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Nama. Ora Mashanda. Oh, come on. Somebody needs to thank God for healing, clothing their marriage with healing. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, God, for clothing our marriages with healing. I thank you, Lord. I thank you. It doesn't necessarily have to be a body. It could be something else that needs to be healed. I thank you for clothing with your healing garments for Eddie Cohen Sr. Amen. Pam Cohen, Mother Moore, Pastor Darden. Amen. Amen. Pastor Darden is sick. He's not feeling well. Oh, we agree. I agree with you. Amen. Amen. Holy Spirit, thanks for hovering over our nation. Yes, yes, that's right. Clothe our nation with healing, Father. Father, we thank you for clothing our nation with healing. We thank you for clothing our nation with healing. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Come on, that's it, guys. Thank you for clothing Clara, Dana, and Nisha with your healing. And Father, amen. Thank you for clothing Patrice Rankin with your healing. In the name of Jesus, the garments of healing. Come on. Etama, Tone Makora Mashaya. Thank you, Lord, for clothing us with healing. Oh, Ramasora Mashaya, the garments of healing. Father, we thank you right now. Lord, we thank you right now. Thank you, Lord, for clothing my family. Amen. I agree. I come into agreement with you. Oh, excuse me. I come into agreement with you, Dana, for my family and your family. Thank you, Father, for clothing my family with the healing, with your healing garments in Jesus' name. Lord, I thank you. Father, I just bless everyone that's up here. And I bless them, Father, that their families are clothed right now with the healing garments of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you, Lord, that you are clothing our family. That, Lord, I release Psalms 91 upon everyone that is up here. God, in the name of Jesus, I release Psalms 91. And I declare, Father, that we are covered, that those that dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And because we abide under the shadow of the Almighty, we thank you, God, that we are protected, we are dressed, we are clothed with the garments of healing. We thank you, oh God. Oh, God bless you, Tracy. Amen. Amen. All the intercessors, yes, prophets, preachers, amen. God bless you, Sister Tracy. I receive that. Amen. We just decree and declare our families are covered under the garment of praise. God is dressing us in, and the protection of the Lord, our Shia, it's like fireproof, it's sickness proof, it's illness proof. The garment of, oh, Rabba, baby, beyond the whole Shababa. Lord, we receive your clothing, we receive your garments. We receive the garment of healing. Thank you for clothing our family. Thank you for clothing us. Thank you, God. And we will put on, oh God, this garment of healing. And we thank you for it right now. That no weapon formed against us shall prosper. In Jesus' name, we thank you, oh God, Lord, that only with our eyes we will behold and see the reward of the wicked. Father, I thank you. Yes, God, the Father, for clothing California and every state in the USA with your garment of healings. Yes, Dana. Hallelujah. We agree. We agree, Dana. We agree with that word. We agree, Dana. Yes, God, we agree with that in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. We are dressed to defeat the enemy of sickness in Jesus' name. I love that. Amen. I love that. I love that. I love that. Father, we thank you. Yes, I receive your garment of healing in my body. I agree with you, prophet. Amen. I agree with you. We are dressed with the garment of healing. Father, we thank you. We thank you right now. We thank you, God, for what you have done tonight. Amen. Dana, what? Dana, yes. Amen. Amen. Father, we receive your word. Oh, God, I just pray, Lord, for everybody that's up here. Father, may we walk in your will. May we forever be in your will. May we forever be covered by your word and your will, God. Oh, God, order our footsteps and direct our path that we will never stray from your will. Oh, God, help us like never before to come into your will and to stay in your will, God, in the name of Jesus. Help us to stay in your will, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Listen, guys, my time has been up. It has been up. Amen. Father, we just thank you for tonight. We thank you for everyone that has come on this prayer line, this Facebook Live. We ask that you bless them. Give us good sleep, God. Let us sleep through the night, God. Let us wake up rejuvenated and ready, oh God, to go back to work. Amen, Mary. God bless you, woman of God. God bless you. Oh, God bless you, Mary. I receive your, oh, I receive it. Amen. I receive the blessing. Amen. Thank you so much. Mary, we come on every night, especially for the next 30 days. We will be on every night. Amen. Some days I do a pop-up one, so just keep a lookout, but we'll be on every night. Some nights it'll be 8 o'clock. Some nights it'll be 9 o'clock. Eastern Standard Time, but I'll be on every night. Please, guys, if you have not shared this video, please share the video. Tracy, share, please. Sister Carolyn Finley, can you please share the video? Can you go share right now? Can everybody share right now if you have not shared? Can you please share right now and just let me know that you have shared the video? I would greatly appreciate it. Amen. We are praying for sweet rest. Guys, September is here. We are getting ready to do the Darcy Burgess mentoring, prophetic mentoring, and intercession. Amen. One-on-one prophetic. Either we're going to mentor you in the prophetic or we're mentoring in intercession. Amen. Dana, please share this video. Thank you, Father, for everyone. No weapon. Amen. Formed against us shall prosper, and any tongue that rises. Amen, Dana. We agree. Amen. Thank you for clothing my husband, John, with the healing garments. Amen. Thank you for clothing my husband, Father, with your healing garments. I agree with that in Jesus' name. Amen. Whenever you can, sis, please join us again. Thank you for sharing the video. We are starting the mentoring class. And the mentoring class and the prophetic and intercession. We are doing a two-day prayer challenge. We are getting ready to do it. I am so excited. Yes, one-on-one with me. Yes, Mary, if you are interested, all you have to do is inbox me your email. We are getting ready. I'm so excited. I know, Henrietta, you don't have to say it. I know. It's finally. Thank you, Tracy, for sharing. God bless you. Dana, please share. Anybody else that just came on, Carolyn Finley, please share. Amen. Listen, we are getting ready for our one-on-one. If you are interested, you have one-on-one time with me. We have a series of sessions that I will be offering. All you have to do is click on and tell me which ones you want, and we will have it. You can thank you, Carolyn, for sharing. God bless you. Prophet Finley, thank you for sharing. God bless you. All you have to do, all you have to do is click on and tell me. Then we're having a two-day prayer challenge. We're going to teach on how you can get your prayers answered. It is an intensive class. It is powerful. It is a two-day, let me do it, two-day challenge, two-day challenge. Some of you have already expressed that you're interested. You're interested. This week, I will be sending out the email with the information, and we are getting ready to start it. I'm not waiting any longer. I'm just going to jump out there and go ahead and do it and believe God. So get ready for the two-day challenge. Get ready for it's only $25 for the 2 days. So for both days, it's a $25 fee for that. And so you can get ready for that. And then we have those of you that want to take the classes, I'll be putting up the prices for that, because those are longer times and everything that we're going to offer with that. So I am extremely excited. I am extremely, extremely, extremely excited. I'm just happy. I'm just really happy about it. Listen, I love you guys. It is 2 hours and 18 minutes that we have been up here. But I know that this was the Lord, and this was something that the Lord wanted us to do. Listen, once again, I got my shirt on. It's 12 at 12. So it's 12 minutes of prayer at midnight. At 12 midnight, it's only 12 minutes of prayer. It's Prophet Andre Cook. Prophet Andre Cook. If you can, please go up there and be a part of his class. Be a part of his 12 minutes at midnight. 12 at 12, 12 minutes. That's all it is to pray. Amen. And we start our day off in prayer. I love you guys. I will see you guys tomorrow night, God's willing. I thank you for clothing my marriage. Amen. I receive that. Thank you, Lord, for clothing my marriage. Amen. With your healing garments. Amen. I love you all, and I look forward to seeing you guys tomorrow night. God bless you. Listen, subscribe to my YouTube page, because all these videos that I do, I post them on my YouTube page, so you can go back and replay them and listen to them again. Love you. I'll see you tomorrow night, God's willing. Good night. Bye-bye. Thank you.